Hey y'all. Before we jump into day 7, I wanted to take a second to say thank you to my Patreon supporters. Your support is greatly appreciated, and it motivates me to keep producing content that meets or hopefully even exceeds your expectations. With that, let's jump right in. Nolf grabs his usual overtie and readies his right arm for the post setup. The post on the opponent's left elbow allows Nolf to beat the hands with a level change. Nolf drives off his back foot and drops to his lead left knee. As Nolf swings his trail leg forward, the opponent defends by wrapping his arms around the waist and shifting his weight onto Nolf's back. Because Nolf brings his trail leg forward, he is able to lift his head up and bring his spine into alignment with his hips. This strong alignment also has the effect of shifting the opponent's weight onto his left leg. Nolf executes the cutback finish by dropping to his right hip and guiding his opponent's hips down to the mat. Today's key concept is alignment. First, a quick shout out to Rob Bernacki and his team at Island Top Team, who have gone deep into this concept and built a whole framework around it, which I found to be a valuable resource. For our purposes today, I'm using alignment to mean getting your hips, shoulders, and head into a relatively vertical position. Coaches implicitly acknowledge alignment when they emphasize the value of getting your head up, your hips in, and your back straight. Some of the benefits of strong alignment include the ability to effectively and efficiently control an opponent and disrupt their alignment or base, i.e. create a positional advantage. Controlling an opponent from a position of alignment is effective because more power can be generated when proper alignment is maintained. For example, anyone who has lifted weights understands the value of maintaining proper form. Proper form or alignment allows for the same individual to lift heavier weights than they would with improper form. Controlling an opponent from a position of alignment is efficient because less energy is exerted when alignment is strong versus when it is weak. For example, consider a situation where a defensive wrestler sprawls and gets the offensive wrestler in an overextended position on the mat. This overextended position can sometimes be salvaged and used to score, but it will generally require a great deal more energy to convert an overextended position into a takedown versus converting an aligned position into a takedown. Another benefit of proper alignment is the ability to better withstand the opponent's attempts to disrupt your alignment. Let's take another look at the clip with this idea of alignment in mind. So here we've got a squared stance. Nolf's gonna bring his right leg back to shift to a staggered stance. He drives off that back foot, drops to his lead knee, reaches for the leg. And now Nolf is gonna do what he often does, which is bring his trail leg forward here. So his right leg is gonna come ripping forward here. And this is going to be especially relevant to this idea of alignment, because what this does is it brings Nolf's hips underneath his shoulders here. And so by bringing his hips underneath his shoulders, it's gonna be easier for Nolf to posture up into this vertical position here. So this is what I'm calling the alignment in this case. So this is head, shoulders, hips in a line here. So it's vertical in this instance. This is gonna be a strong position for Nolf. It's gonna be especially conducive to this cutback finish. You can see he's still controlling the opponent's left leg. Nolf's gonna drop to his right hip and get the finish here. So you often hear in wrestling the cues, and they're good, the idea of head up, hips in, back straight. What these cues are talking about is really this concept of alignment here. So that's the goal. It's especially, I would say alignment, it's important no matter what, but it's especially important, I would say, from the knees, because the more that your hips and shoulders are not aligned, so like say from this position here, if Nolf weren't to bring his right leg forward, it becomes increasingly difficult to posture up from the knees in this position here when the opponent puts weight. So getting the hips underneath is crucial here. And you can see once the knee is there, it's relatively easy for Nolf to posture up, elevate the opponent, and get the finish here. So again, staggered stance, drops to the left leg, brings that right back leg, ripping forward here, and then gets in this good alignment. So when you guys are analyzing your own film and maybe you took a shot, it didn't work, the opponent defended, they sprawled perhaps, take a look at your alignment, because there's a good chance that something went off with your alignment. Maybe your opponent did a good job getting you out of alignment, or maybe your setup didn't work out and you weren't able to get in close enough. But if you are successfully able to get your hips in and get your hips underneath your shoulders and get your head up, like in this position here, it's gonna be really hard for your opponent to defend, and it's gonna be relatively easy for you to get a finish as opposed to when you're in a more extended position. One more time on the clip. That's it for day 7. Thanks for watching.